It doesn't get any more interesting than this. The final night of season four and the first of two games in the night features one really big game between the Chicago Wolves and the Manitoba Moose. If the Moose win, they are in and the Wolves are out. If the Wolves win, they stay alive for the final game, the 10:30 games, tonight here in Week 9. Hi, everyone. T-Sims with you. Vibes is with me as well. And we are talking Moose, Wolves, and if any of you listen to our weekly show, you know that several weeks back, and I wish I had the cut right now, Vibes, Vibes told you that the Wolves were going to be in trouble. And could this have come down to any more of a pinnacle game than the final night of regular season? Vibes, you look like a soothsayer at this point. And right now the Wolves are struggling to try and make the playoffs. What did you see way back when that made you feel that this was going to be a real struggle for the Wolves?
Well, I mean, it's like I've said a couple times now. You know, I don't want to say that HJ was carrying the Wolves, but he was carrying a big brunt of the Wolves. And I feel like with his departure, once he moved on, it really just made the Wolves a mediocre team. You know, they're not a bad team, but they're just mediocre. They're just your average run of the pack, you know? Not bad, not good, just in the middle. And it seemed to me like moving forward, they were going to have trouble because they... And not only are they mediocre as a team, they're just mediocre in all areas of the ice. And they have subpar goaltending. No offense to the goaltenders on the team, one of which is a good friend of mine, and he's a great person, but they have subpar goaltending. And I just knew they were in trouble. And we'll see what happens tonight. I would say this is the biggest game of the year, but this is the year. This is the season. Like, there is no more season. It's tonight. That's it. This is it. It's all that's left.
You know, you make a great point, and we talked about HJ getting called up late February. It was, I believe, February 25th, just before week four started. And to give you some perspective on this, Prince of Zeus, who is second in scoring on the team right now, he's tied with Maddens for that lead. He was 7-0-1 in the first 3 weeks of the season, just before HJ was traded. Since then, he has 5-8-4 since HJ was called up, and that right there tells you how much of a difference it made for Zeus, at least on that line, and certainly. You know, for the entire Chicago Wolves team, what was really Vibes, their top line, really suffered tremendously with that move. And were they there even their second line at that point? I don't even know. They really suffered big time. I wasn't sure if that was absolutely the case, but I tell you, you hit the nail on the head when it happened, and it was a bigger loss than anyone I think could have anticipated.
Yeah, no, it really was. And, you know, AJ moving up, it just completely threw off the dynamics of the team. And, you know, again, with all respect due to everybody on that team, you know, I don't want to badmouth anybody, but, you know, a bunch of pretty average players, you know, like even Zeus, you know, all of them, they're all just average, maybe a little bit above average, a few of them. But HJ was really the brunt. And with him gone, it just changed everything, changed absolutely everything. And, you know, since that point in time, they really haven't had many winning weeks, right? How many weeks have they actually had a winning record in? Not that many.
No. They've struggled just about every week since then. Lot of up and down weeks, and it really has been, a big problem. They were kind of holding their own for a little bit, but they really could not gain any ground, and then started slipping little by little. And the Moose, who hung around the whole time, they started to play better, and then that was that.
Yep. Yes, it was.
Well, we got a chance to catch up with MGML again to talk to him about tonight's game and get a little bit of perspective from him leading into this very important game for these two teams. MGM joins me on the pregame show again. It seems like this is the Manitoba Moose channel lately, MG, but you guys have been in the thick of the playoff race, and you've had some pretty interesting games. And tonight, I don't think it can get any more interesting in the final night of the final week of the regular season where you play the Chicago Wolves, and if you take this one, you're in, the Wolves are out, the checkers are in, a lot riding on one game. How are your guys feeling going into this one tonight?
I think we're feeling pretty good. I mean, obviously, we understand the implications of what this game is, but I think we just have to stick with what we've been doing all week. I think we've had a good week. I think we really focused on what we need to do to get into the playoffs, and I think it's going to be a good game for sure.
Now, you've got an interesting lineup going tonight, and this front line of Bear, Dane, and Kev Robert, you know, some interesting players here. You know, Bear's third in scoring on the team. You know, Kev, he's the fifth leading scorer on your team. And then you throw in Dane, who has a lot of experience in this league, but wasn't doing an awful lot for your team going into the last couple of weeks. Now, all of a sudden, he is a starting center in a very important game. Tell us what kind of experience, you know, what Dane's experience is going to mean in this important game.
Dane's been with us all season. He's been up and down in the lineup,
right.
But he's been with us all season, practicing with us all season. He's comfortable with the team. He knows how to play. He's a good player. I think we all have confidence that he's going to be able to get the job done tonight for us.
And you guys certainly, you and Funky on defense, and Archmangus again in goal. You know, he's been a tremendous backstop for you guys. Certainly the last couple of weeks especially, he's been a real big game saver for you. How are you guys as far as a defensive core? You know, how do you feel about this game against Chicago? What do you feel that you need to do to stop, you know, certainly a formidable line in Zeus, Spider, and Madden's?
Yeah, well, I mean, I think you can tell the Wolves are a little nervous with their late line change, throwing Madden's in there. Obviously, they're trying to throw everything at us, but I feel confident, especially with our D and goaltending, team defense as well. I think we're very structured, and I think we'll be able to shut them down.
Yeah, and they've got a, you know, solid lineup here, but, you know, one guy who has been struggling for them is String King. Since coming over from the Americans, he's had a tough time on that side. Is that something you guys might look to exploit?
I think we have to take advantage of any opportunities that we can take advantage of. But I don't think it's going to change our game plan. I think we're just going to play our game, and we'll see what happens.
You guys, certainly a couple of nights ago, a tough loss against Charlotte, but it's been your only backward step of recent time. You guys have continued on a good win streak. 7-1 so far in this week, 8 out of your last 9 going back to the win last Thursday. This really kind of sounds, well, it's kind of, you know, giving a marker here that the Moose have decided that, you know, you guys are going to make the playoffs. You're going to do everything you can to get there. Has that been the overall feel from everybody that you've talked to in the team? Are they just giving it their all at this point?
Yeah, I think everyone's been really focused this week. Really good with practicing, and just we're just taking it one game at a time. And yeah, other than the Charlotte game, and really, I mean, Charlotte's just kind of had our number this year for whatever reason. Mm-hmm. We just seem to kind of step over ourselves or step on top of ourselves when we play Charlotte, but I think we shook that off and came back and had a big win against the Monsters, and have just continued pushing for that final spot.
You feel like there is any specific key to this game tonight? I mean, Chicago obviously has been struggling of late, but you know they're still in the playoff hunt, and you've got to take them, you know, at that. Is there any specific, well, not specific, but is there any general feel about how you have to play this game tonight against the Wolves?
I think one of the big keys for us is going to have to be to stay out of the penalty box. I know we have a tendency sometimes to get into penalty trouble, and it's easy to fall behind early when you start taking penalties. So I think other than limiting the power plays that we give the Wolves, I think just trying to get the go-ahead goal and not have to play from behind will be a big key as well.
I know you've been running playoff drops tonight, and I'm sure you want to get back to that before your game starts up, maybe for one more. But what have you been telling you guys tonight in your warmups?
Just to stay positive and know that we have the talent on this team to win this game and make the playoffs. None of us want to leave it up to chance. We want to finish this first game and solidify our spot in the postseason.
MG, best of luck to you tonight. Thanks again for joining us, and hopefully we'll talk to you after a win tonight and get a chance to see what that feels like for you guys making the playoffs if you can take this game.
Yep, here's hoping. Thanks very much, Sibs.
MGML 1987 again joining me on the pregame show, and at this point, Vibes, I think I struggled trying to figure out what to ask him, and he struggled trying to figure out what to say differently than he's been saying for the last couple of weeks. And you know, that's the way it is. It's been heads down hockey for them for several weeks now, just to keep themselves in the playoff race. And now that they find themselves so close, you don't want to take the foot off the gas right now.
No, absolutely not. And, you know, I feel like that's the one advantage maybe going over to the Manitoba Moose tonight is that, hey, look, they've been on the outside looking in pretty much all year, and they've been hungry, you know, and like when you're out there, you know, you're out there in the wilderness, and you know, you got your eye on the prize, on the meat, so to speak, you know, and you just want to get there. You want to get there. And all season, it's been eluding you. And then on the other hand, you got the Chicago Wolves, who, you know, they've been in all year. And I feel like in a lot of ways, when I said what I said weeks ago, it was kind of laughed off as, yeah, okay. And I think that sentiment was throughout, you know, the entire lineup, really. And I think they kind of expected to be there and expected to be in the playoffs. And now all of a sudden, they're on the outside looking in. And how does that affect them? You know, does the sentiment of, you know, oh, we're going to be fine, really lull them to sleep and have them lose tonight? Or does it, you know, kick anything in for them? And I don't know. And I feel like in that respect, you got to say advantage goes to the Moose, right?
Yeah, I think also all the momentum is just going their way. It's awfully hard to stop what they've been able to do, and for Chicago all of a sudden to be able to try and start it back up again. You know, it is so hard to do that and to stop the slide that they've been on and be able to go out there now and produce a game that's going to keep them alive. But you know, this is the time you have to do it. If you could blow out everything else that's been going on for the last half a season for these guys in Chicago. If they can do something and just miraculously get into the playoffs tonight, they don't have to think about that anymore. All they got to think about then is their first round matchup. They can look back at what happened and maybe think about it in the offseason and figure out what they're going to do moving forward. But, you know, it all... This game is just, you know, obviously just as important to them, and they've got a lot of work to do in order to try and get past what's been a very, very tough and very hot Manitoba Moose with a goaltender who has also been incredibly hot in Ark Mangus.
Yeah. And, you know, if the Wolves win tonight, it everything that we've said and everything that's happened, you know, and the fact that they've struggled and everything else, it all goes away. You know what I mean? If they can pull this off, it all goes away. And that's something that they do have to think about, the fact that you just got to go win a game. You know, and the playoffs are still yours. They're yours to be taken, you know, and that's what they have to carry in. But on the other hand, they're playing a very good lineup tonight. You know, they have Funky Shyster, who was a defenseman for me in season one. And then they have MG on the back end, and those are two defensemen that are, you know, tough to get around. They know how to take the line. They take the straight line back, and they know how to do it. And then on the other end with Chicago, you know, you have String King, who can be a little bit shaky at times, especially around, you know, the offensive blue line. You can get in behind him. And, you know, is a guy like Kev Robert going to be able to get in past him and take advantage of him? And I don't know. It's a tough one.
Yeah, and it's a very interesting lineup. And we've talked about this before, Vibes. You're looking at the Moose lineup with Dane and Kev Robert, two guys who, you know, who've played the game well, who've had their ups and downs in this game. Kev was traded over to us over in Tucson last season, couldn't make any games after that, wound up not being able to contribute to our team, and Dane on the other side, suspended for season two, finally came back last season, found himself up and down this season, a guy who's contributed since season one, and now, you know, maybe not knowing what was going to happen, now he finds himself in a big game. And then on the other side, you know, String King, another guy who was a big player season one, but then has struggled since. And we've seen this with guys who were part of this league the first couple of seasons. Then all of a sudden, 3 and 4, they find themselves on the outs. We've got some guys here, just in Dane and String King, who maybe can contribute and show everyone, yeah, you know what, we're still pretty good players in this league.
Yeah, not only that, but, you know, they bring a huge veteran presence to the table. You know, String King, you know, you got the veteran defenseman there on the left side. And then with Dane, you know, a veteran center, you know. So they've been here before, you know. They've been down this road, and they know what it takes to win. So it is nice to have that in the lineup, you know, a solid, sound presence that, you know, if people get riled up and, you know, like if you do go down 1-0 or 2-0, whatever, you know, you're going to have that presence and that voice telling you, come on, guys, we're fine, let's just keep going. So that can help them. But at the same time, you know, especially String King, he is known, he can be susceptible to being taken advantage of, especially at that blue line, you know, as the other team's coming out of their zone. He has been known to make mistakes and get twisted around, and next thing you know, you have a break going the other way. So it's definitely going to be interesting to watch.
And String is an interesting case. He came over from the Americans after week 6. And since then, and you figure coming onto a better team with Chicago, he's been 1-8, a minus 21 back on defense. And so he definitely has something to prove tonight. And if the Wolves can play some solid D and keep the Moose off the scoreboard, and win this one in a low-scoring game, it could be some serious retribution for him. He's lucky enough to have Ironman on the other side, who is, as for a defenseman on the right side, he is their ninth leading scorer in Chicago. He's a plus 18, and in week 8, he faced the Comets, the Sens, and the Marlies. He had a goal, 3 assists, and a plus 9 against all three of those teams. So he has been ready to play. He has played well of late. And that defense with Cosmo and Net, we'll see if they're able to hold off the Moose. But they're going to need, and that's why I brought it up to MG. Chicago's going to need something from String King. They're going to need a really good game from him tonight to have a chance of holding the Moose down off the scoreboard.
Absolutely. And you mentioned Iron Man. You know, maybe he can pitch in a little bit from the back end and maybe help the Wolves, you know, get a goal or two here early on, you know, maybe from the back end, maybe a shot from the point or something. But it is going to be, you know, it's a really tough call because if I was going to go one way or the other in this particular game, even though I did say the Wolves would be out of the playoffs and they would not make the playoffs, I think the Wolves are going to find a way to win this game. I like who they have up front. You know, I like Mattins and then Spider is a very he's a very deliberate forward, and I feel like he could give the defenseman of the Manitoba Moose a little bit of trouble. So I do like that for them, and I think they're going to end up pulling this one out. I don't know. I just feel like the Wolves are going to win this one.
So after all that, Vibes is telling you he thinks that they're going to pull this one out.
Yeah, I think I'm going to end up being wrong tonight. Yeah. I do.
Well, I do. Just to look at the Western Central standings, as you see the teams who are still in it, obviously Iowa, Cleveland, have clinched to well ahead. Charlotte on a five-game winning streak at 95 points. The Moose right there at 95. They've won three in a row. And again, the story, as you've seen for several weeks now with Chicago, on a two-game losing streak, 2 points back. And so they cannot afford a loss of any kind tonight. We hope that this is going to prove to be a very interesting game of two teams really, really battling. And you know what, Vibes? Manitoba wants this one just as much because they don't want to have to rely on a win over the Wild in the 10:30 game to be their saving grace.
Yeah, that's definitely not the safe bet. That's not where you want to put your money. So they want to win this. Not only just because it's the Wild, but just because, you know, once you lose this game, if you drop this game, then you start getting into the, you know, well, if this team wins, but that team loses, well, then we're in, but then we might be tied. And then if we're tied, oh, we get the tiebreaker. And it's just, oh, my God, what's going on? Win this game and you're in, right? And then you don't got to talk to anybody. You don't got to ask nobody for nothing. You made your own way. You're in. You win it. You're in it. And that's got to be the mindset moving forward.
Well, as you can see, the Moose are in their dressing room right now. They are the home team. And so I'm not sure if I guess they've gotten some word that they need to wait a little bit for Chicago to get set up. But we're hoping to have this game underway soon and a challenge sent out. And as soon as we see that happening, we'll let you know. But at this point, we're still waiting.
Were we able to get all the tiebreaker scenarios, or were we not able to obtain that information?
I haven't seen that yet. And I got to tell you, I went over the rule book, and I, you know, maybe I just missed it, but I could not find it.
Yeah, I was looking, I believe, and hopefully maybe we'll get a little bit of help from the audience. I believe it's regulation wins and then goals four, I think. Maybe someone could help us out and figure that out for us, but I think that's the way it goes.
Well, there was some talk about how Chicago would have a tiebreaker over the Moose, and I don't remember exactly what that was about. And unfortunately, we haven't been able to get any answers yet today about all the tiebreakers. And so, certainly, we'll try and get the official word to you as soon as we get some information. But we're still waiting right now to get some confirmation on that. But yeah, this is one that, and hey, look, not even this one. This is another, there were a couple of other games and situations tonight that, yeah, that are interesting. You've got the Roadrunners and the Gulls a point apart right now. And of course you've got, the Thunderbirds, who with a win in their 9:30 game can clinch a playoff spot there over the Sound Tigers. They are, Thunderbirds taking on Hartford in their first game, and Vibes will be bringing us updates as to what's going on with that one as we go along. So a lot of hockey to watch, and after this game, if there are still any matchups that might be of interest, we will try and go to those games live and take a look in and just do some commentary on them as we go along. But this one, certainly the biggest game of the night, and we will be bringing it to you shortly as both teams have now entered the matchup, and there are no changes. As we can see, everyone's still the same teams as we saw before. Dane, Bear, Kev Robert up front for the Moose. MG and Funky at D. Ark Mangus, the goaltender for the Moose. And on the other side, as you quickly saw and then didn't see, it is Zeus, Spider, and Madden's up front. String King, Iron Man on the D. And Cosmo in net, a guy who they picked up early in the season as just a stray pickup, and he is now an integral part in this game. Another guy with plenty of experience in this game. And so we're about ready for face-off here as the teams
line
up.
Don't get much better than this.
We are underway in a very important game between the Wolves and the Moose, and the Moose control. Pass over to Bear, and he is not able to get off a clean shot. Now back the other way is Zeus. Off to Iron Man, shot on net. Good save by Ark, and he'll hold on to it.
Sibs, I can see it right away. Both these teams are coming out ready to do this.
Moose win the faceoff, get it out of the zone. See if they call that an icing. It will not be, as apparently Iron Man was too close to the puck when it came out, and so now Chicago will start up again. Iron Man hit off the puck, and a good check there by Kev Robert, who now is holding it on the right side. Shot is blocked. Puck is loose. Now kick back out, and Zeus trying to start up with it. Iron Man pulls up in the slot. Had Zeus open, but Zeus could not connect. And now the Moose starting out. Bear picks up a loose puck. Good save by Cosmo. Got a little stuck on the ice, but now back up, and the Wolves are able to clear. First period, no score, and a very big game. Glad you're with us here on LG and the YouTube channel. T. Sibs and Vibes with all the action here as Chicago again trying to start up. Zeus gets a clear shot, but a wide shot. Good save by Ark.
He was able to step around him and come out of the corner. I thought he might have had one there.
Dane wins the faceoff. MG trying to find an out there, having a little bit difficulty, but finally they get it up to Kev Robert. Pass is tipped off and now taken back by Maddens. A little bit of room there, but a good poke check by Dane and gets that puck off his stick. Good raise for the puck.
Just missed the breakaway.
Bear has it. Looking for someone. Not getting approached. Now finally puts it behind the net. Dane trying to get control. Finally does. Has a man in front. Tries to get it in front, but partially blocked by Cosmo. And now Chicago comes back the other way. Maddens. Zeus shot. Looking for a rebound for Maddens, but a good cover up by Ark, and he'll hold. Good action so far in this first period as the Moose try to get control and bring it out. Kev flips it in. Iron Man gets it up over the string. Now Maddens. Maddens, good defensive play, no room. And a good shot there by Zeus, but a great glove save by Ark Mangus, and he'll hold.
That was going in.
Chicago won the faceoff, but the Moose broke it up. They're trying to start out now. Kev trying to get it back to Bear, who's deep, but not able to. Now the puck shot out. This will be an icing on Chicago.
Right now, advantage Wolves.
Faceoff deep in the Chicago end. Puck fought for, and now good save there by Cosmo off the shot from Kev. And now flip back out. Under 4 minutes left to go in the first period as Chicago trying to keep the puck in. And they do as Funky tried to get it out but was not able to. Good shot. Couple of good saves by Ark as he was able to keep it out of the net. Those loose pucks right in front, Vibes, they would scare the daylights out of me in a game like this.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Iron Man flips it in. Now Bear has it, and he starts out for the Moose. Kev Robert. Shot and a save. Now puck pushed in front, but Bear cannot find anybody, and Chicago breaks it up and starts out. Zeus, under a minute left to go in the first period. Zeus behind the net, tries a wrap. It is held on to by Ark. He just got over in time.
Tricky play.
Faceoff almost on net. Chicago gets it back. Zeus, pass out front. Good shot by Maddens, but Ark was in perfect position. Chicago will get it with a couple of seconds left to go in the period, and we will end the first without a tally as both teams playing tough. And you see four shots for the Moose, seven for Chicago. Good opportunities, too, but as we mentioned, Vibes, Ark Mangus could be a big difference in this one.
Yeah, and right now he's keeping him in it because it seems to me like the defense of the Manitoba Moose is having some trouble with the crisscrossing speedy foe to the Wolves, and right now it feels like the Wolves are giving it to him a little bit. But score is still nothing, so hang tight.
Second period about to get underway. T. Sibbs vibes with you in this critical game in the Western Central. Chicago in the zone. Shot by Maddens, and Ark Magnus will hold on to it. As you see, faceoffs are close with Chicago and Manitoba now tied with five each. And that's how tight this whole game is right now. Maddens gets it in the zone. Can't find anybody. Good stick check there by MG. And now walking in with it was String King. I'm going to get a penalty on the Moose. It looks like Dane is going to go off. And the Moose will have to kill a penalty. Good intercept there by Bear as he killed some time.
Now just a couple updates.
Yep.
We have Springfield 1-0 up in their game, and Bridgeport also up 1-0 in their game.
Good pass over to Maddens. Tries to find somebody. Puck not cleared out, and a loose puck in front as Maddens is able to put it home. Maddens from Zeus at 3:14 to give Chicago the 1-0 lead. Now puck is down in the loose zone. They start back out with it. Bear up to Kev Robert. Loose shot as you hear it ring off the post. Almost snuck by Cosmo. And now another shot. Good save by Cosmo off the shot by Kev Robert. And Chicago will start out. Here's the Moose trying to start something up again. Chicago jamming up the middle as Dane is trying to get something into the zone, but it's broken up and now taken. Now Dane intercepts a nice pass. Gets hit a couple of times on the board, and now Chicago with the break. Here comes Bear. And Zeus with the goal. Defensive lapse there. And Zeus from String King for the second goal of the game, and Chicago now up 2-0. This cannot be making the Moose incredibly happy at this point.
No. Tucson and San Jose are tied 1-1.
Another game of importance. Tucson and San Diego both fighting for that last spot in the Western Pacific. Now the Moose, again, needing to start out. You're almost seeing like a 1-3-1 a bit by Chicago, trying to jam up that middle. And this time the Moose are able to break it. Good check there by Iron Man. And now Zeus will start back with it. Good shot on net. And again, Ark Magnus has seen a lot of action so far, and he'll hold and get another faceoff. Zeus from String King at 8:26, making it 2-0 in this one. Zeus, a goal and an assist so far in this game.
Tell you what, Sibs, the Moose haven't been able to get much going here.
They've really been stymied at the red line, Vibes, and it's been a tough go for them. Another pass almost getting through, and that would have been dangerous. Now a good snapshot. Quick one by Bear, and that goes over the net. He's got it back, trying again. Another shot partially blocked by Iron Man. Kev back to Dane, back of the net. Puck comes out front. It's still loose, and now finally picked up by String King. And he'll start out with it up to Spider. Now Zeus over to Maddens. Good passing there on that play for Chicago, but Again, another stop by Art Mangus. Chicago looking to get it out. Hitting the 2-minute mark now in the second period. Good block on the shot there. MG trying to control it. Puck squirts out for Zeus, but he can't get control for it. Under a minute now in the second. Kev Robert kicks it in. Bear picks it up. Looking for something in front. They're jamming the middle. Finally gets a puck off. A good shot there by Kev Robert, but it was just wide. He had that side of the net.
And did not miss by much.
And so the Moose find themselves in a precarious situation at this point. Down 2-0 to Chicago. It was no score after the first, and two goals now by Chicago. Maddens from Zeus at 3:14 to make it 1-0, and then Zeus from String King at 8:26 gets us at the 2-0 Chicago lead at the second intermission.
You know, I don't know if the Moose forwards are waiting for an invitation or something, but, you know, someone on that bench needs to let them know that it's okay to score, that you're welcome to score, so let's get it going, because they haven't been able to do much at all.
14 shots on goal from Chicago, as you see, 7-4 of the Moose, and, you know, that's been a lot of work for Art Mangus and a lot of opportunities. The breakaway, though, that cannot be allowed in a big game like this, Vibes.
No, absolutely not. Definitely pin that guy to the bench.
We start the third period. And the Moose will control. They need something soon. Good check there. Puck now finally pushed out by Zeus. Spider throws it in. Maddens picks it up. Trying to find somebody in front. Spider's getting bounced around. He doesn't have quite an opening just yet. Now the puck is loose. Almost squirts out the Spider, but goes wide. Maddens had the wrap. Could not execute it and hits off the post. Gets it again. Tries a wrap again. This time Art Mangus holds on to it. And a third goal right now, Vibes, would just be devastating to the Moose.
Yeah. They score again, we could shut this off, go get a drink.
The Moose are really got to be a bit surprised by what's going on in this game so far. Starting out with it, Dane. He's got pretty much five guys jamming him in. He still gets it off to Kev Robert, who could not get off a clean shot.
Thought they had that one there.
Pass all the way over to Iron Man. He gets off a shot, but it goes wide. Now Dane trying to find Kev, but is not able to connect with him. Dane pops it off of Zeus's stick. Now MG trying to clear it out. Bear moving up on the left side. Pulls up, gets hit, but it's kept in by MG. Good quick shot on net. The puck is loose. Still loose. Bouncing around in front of the net. Finally goes behind the net, and that was a close one. Oh. Funky gets it up to Dane. Dane gets past the defense. Looking to get in the front. Gets it off to Bear, who cannot get a clean shot off. Partially saved by Cosmo and kicked back out again. Now the Moose are pressing harder. More offensive opportunities. Bear. Saved by Cosmo in the corner. Bear picks it up again. Pass out front and a score by Dane. Great pass by Bear to Dane. And actually, they're going to give it to Bear unassisted, so it must have gone off of a defender for that goal.
A little late to the party, but all right.
Well, they're getting opportunities, and now another one deep in the Chicago zone. As they start out with it now, Zeus. Shot is blocked. Now the Moose starting back out again. Pass goes wide. Dane trying to get it back. Kevro Bear, couple of deflections. Puck is loose in front. Still loose. And there will be a... I guess they're going to say it was a hold by Cosmo. Guess he covered that one up. Bear unassisted at 10:04 to get this one at 2-1 now. The Moose finally getting on the board. Now puck is loose. And just held on to Cosmo, got out there just before Kevro Bear was able to get a stick on that and do something with it. And so we're going to have a timeout being called by the Manitoba Moose as this game gets real interesting real quickly.
Thunderbirds are up 4-0 in their game.
They hold on. They're going to be in, and that'll be it for the Tigers. We got 6:06 left to go in this third period.
Of the Tucson is up 3-2.
We get back to the action on this one now. The Moose will control. Kev Robert gets it across to MG. Shot off on net. Save and a deflection. Now Kev Robert has it. Almost tried to get the wrap there, but could not get it fully executed. Now Zeus.
MG.
Good push off a play, but Zeus gets it back. Has a couple of men in front. The shot there was saved by Ark. He just got a pad on it and pushed it aside.
If they tie this up, remember that one.
Bear trying to get it. Almost had it past his defender. And the Moose are playing incredibly hard now. Another save by Ark. He's trying to lock down any opportunity right in front.
Don't let him just hold the puck like that.
Zeus just whittling away in the corner without any defensive pressure. 1:13 left to go in the third period. Faceoff. And now up the other way, Funky Shyster. Looking to get something going, but it's a good deflection there. And now Chicago, Zeus controlling again. 45 seconds left to go. Kev Robert gets it. Flips it back over to Funky Shyster. Now they're looking to try and move this puck up. Dane gets it. And they're jamming up the middle, trying to stop them from getting in the zone. Chicago successful so far, and they flip it all the way down. Will not be an icing as Funky Shyster has it. 20 seconds left to go in the period. Here's Kev Robert. He can't get anything going. Shyster, shot. It's a good save by Cosmo. Flipped aside. MG keeps it in. His shot gets deflected. 6 seconds left to go. Chicago gets control. They're going to flip it out, and they're going to win this game. The Chicago Wolves have proven vibes right once again with a 2-1 victory over the Manitoba Moose. And now the Moose, they're going to have any kind of chance. They need to beat the Wild in the 10:30 game. And that is going to be, look, it was a tall order for them to do it against Cleveland a couple of nights ago. It's no easier, no worse than anything else that they had to do that night. But they have put themselves in a situation now where it is going to be incredibly tough for them to do anything to have any control of their own destiny. And right now, Chicago has proven to be a thorn in the side of the Moose in this one, Vibes, and playing great defense, jamming up the middle, not giving the Moose much opportunity the first two periods of this game. Finally, the Moose broke through, but definitely a case of too little too late in this one for them.
Yeah, definitely. And I think we need to find out what the tiebreak scenarios are, because right now, Manitoba and Chicago would be tied. I'm trying to get a score from the Checkers' first game, because if the Checkers won, then that's it. They're in, right?
If they're ahead by 3, yes. I believe that's the case.
Yeah, if they won, they're in. Let me see if I can get a score on that one.
Yeah, we're trying to give you some updates as to what else is going on in the other games tonight. And we'll Vibes is working on that as well. But 18 total shots on goal for Chicago. So they only got four off in that third period, as that was definitely a 6-4 shots on goal advantage for the Moose in that one. But only really dominating one period in this game and not able to get any kind of good opportunity to take this game. And so, what an interesting one. Just about as good as we thought it would be.
Excellent. Excellent game right down to the wire. I feel like the Moose had to get it going a little bit earlier than they did. And then coming down those waning minutes of the third, man, it was, you know, I was on the edge of my seat. I'm actually sweating. You know, I need to go get a towel and dry up a little bit because I'm sweating from watching that game. The Checkers are up 6-1 in their game, so the Checkers are going to be in, and it's going to come down to the Moose and the Wolves. Who are the Wolves playing in that second game?
Because the Wolves have the Cleveland Monsters, and so that is another tough game.
So they're both playing pretty tough teams.
And if we're lucky enough, we may be able to go back and forth between the two games. So let's see how this works out.
I'll make sure I have that one up at least. If we're not going to flip through it on the broadcast, I'll at least have it up.
Well, I think that's what we're going to endeavor to do, is show you both of those games and give you some perspective of what's going on, if there's another race going on. We're going to have Prince of Zeus on here shortly to talk about this one and see how the Wolves are feeling after this incredibly clutch victory. A heck of a game all around. And, we said it in the pregame, String King and that defense, Iron Man, String King, Cosmo, solid defense all the way through. String had an assist on one of the goals in this game. He played the game he needed to for Chicago to have a chance.
He did, but I'll tell you what, Sibs, the Moose, they didn't attack him enough, because the one goal that they did score, it came from the left side of the ice, the left side of the defense. So I feel like if they could have maybe tried to attack him more, make him come out and play the puck, play the offensive winger a little bit more, I think they would have had a little bit more luck, as opposed to constantly going and trying to attack Iron Man, because Iron Man had everything under control. And then the one goal they do score, it does come from that left side of the Wolves defense, String King side. And I think if they could have maybe tried to find a way to do that more, maybe they could have gotten another one. Who knows? But nonetheless, String did play a good game, and their whole defense did. So.
Well, it was an incredibly interesting game, and we're going to have Prince of Zeus on here very shortly. Just connecting up with him right now, and as soon as he jumps on, we'll talk to him about this game.
Tucson and San Jose tied at 5.
And so another big game here. Prince of Zeus joins us now. Congratulations on this win. Boy, I don't think you could have gotten any more of a clutch performance out of your team tonight than you did in this game.
Yeah, it's definitely been long overdue. We've been slumping as a unit, but we realized tonight, like about 2 hours ago, I thought we were out, like for sure. They were like, oh, we still have a chance. And I was like, oh, I'm in both games. Oh, we have a really good chance now. So hopefully we can carry that into game two.
What was your general strategy going into this one with the Moose? What did you think you needed to do against them? Besides
we needed to just play offensive and not defensive. That's literally all it is. We made a team decision going in. We were like, okay, we're going to attack, 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 and not stop until we win. And that's kind of what we did. We just made sure we kept the pressure up all game and didn't let off for even a moment. And it paid off.
Your defense tonight, we talked a little bit about in the pregame, you've got Iron Man back there who's had a hell of a season, and you've got a veteran talent in String King who has struggled this season, especially since he came over with you guys. He had an assist tonight. He played, what he needed. He did what he needed to do for the most part. Talk about your defense tonight, and more specifically, what String King was able to do to help you out.
What String King was able to do was actually win us the game. Because if his pass didn't reach me, I don't score. And he hit me on a dime on a breakaway, and I don't usually miss those, thankfully. But yeah, no. He shut it down for the most part. We had to use a substitute in Slow. Slow had issues and he couldn't make tonight's games, which right. was kind of a downer. But we didn't let us like beat us up over it. So we trying to find another defender that can play at the moment because Slow can't play the next game either.
Right.
So hopefully we pull it out.
Do you have anything going on with the lineup that sure. That's still up for grabs for this game against Cleveland?
We have to use an ECU more than likely. Most of our roster D-men are not available to play either a fourth game or they've already played four games.
Gotcha.
So
even with that extra availability, it still wasn't enough for you guys tonight.
Yeah, pretty much.
Talk a little bit. We haven't been able to talk an awful lot lately about the last several weeks of your season. And you mentioned it, certainly, sliding ever so slowly down back to Charlotte and the Moose. What were you telling your team during that time period? What were you trying to get across to them as this was happening to you guys?
I will not lie. I was probably the worst GM this season when it came down to that. I was legitimately labeling our team chat LG's free win team because we were losing so much. And we tried to correct it. We shifted the lines up a little bit. We tried playing different styles and like nothing seemed to be working. So we just kind of tried going back to Smash Mouth hockey this last week, and even that didn't work out. But this last game, it really helped out, thankfully. But even this last week, I mean, we were winning a lot, and people weren't willing to really to play as a team itself, just because, you know, the game itself is bad. Like, NHL 17 is a horrible game. But, I mean, it's more about this being my final season that I kind of wanted to push through. Like, I could have quit, like, 3 or 4 weeks ago, and I didn't want to, because it was going to be my final year.
Nice. So. We're gonna take a quick look here at your breakaway goal as the Moose are bringing it into the zone, and there is a String King with a good defensive play hitting you, splitting the defense on that play, and then of course you finishing it off with a nice final moment on that play. Again, good defensive play by String on that one, and then of course a good pass right after that. That really, to me, is the epitome of a guy who's been in this league long enough, and he knows what he needs to do in a certain situation. He spotted you immediately and got the puck right on the tape.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I was calling middle before he even got the puck, just because I could see it developing just like he did, which was awesome. So it was like, at that point, if I get a pass like that, I have to score. There's no way I can't, because if I don't, then it kind of just kills the team's morale.
So what are you looking to do here in this game against Cleveland? Obviously, they are a formidable team. They've been that way all season long. You have to win this one to stay in it. What's your strategy going into this one tonight?
Don't let a repeat of what happened. I think it was earlier, mm-hmm. like either earlier this week or the week before. Or it was like a 13-6 loss or some shit.
Yeah.
Just don't let that happen. That's really all we can really hope for. Aside from that, don't lose.
Well, a man of usually many words, but I guess on game night, there's really only a few things you can actually say when it comes down to the last two games of the season to get yourself in the playoffs. Listen, Zeus, best of luck in this game, too. I know you're in there again with Spider and Madden's. And Cosmo and Ironman, best of luck in this one, and we'll be following it. We'll be taking a look at it, and hopefully you guys can can look past this slide you've been having and get yourselves into the playoffs. Best of luck to you.
Thanks, man. Final shout-out to pretty much everyone on my team, but especially Madden's for putting up with my bullshit pretty much all year.
Thanks, Prince. Appreciate it. Talk to you later, buddy.
See ya.
Prince of Zeus here on the show, Chicago Wolves GM, joining us after that big win. And you know, we saw a very interesting game, one that was, you know, some good plays early on, vibes, but still, I almost said a couple of times, it still looks like these guys are a little tight, like nobody wants to make that mistake. But eventually, it was a flinch by the Moose who allowed Zeus to be there and be on that breakaway. And that is that momentary lapse, that one mistake that leads them down the road to a loss. And those are the things that can happen in a flash and cost you the season.
Yeah, and you got to wonder what happened. You got to wonder if maybe, you know, a butterfly landed on one of the defensemen's wall or something like that. Something caught their attention because they weren't there on that one. And to let a guy come right down Broadway like that, it's definitely a mistake, whether it be a mental error or just an error on the ice. I don't know, but definitely a mistake to let Zeus just come right down the middle, coming in on your goaltender, and ended up being the difference in the game. So
we're going to take a look at that again and just hopefully we can I'll try and stop the play here as we get there. But as you see, Dane is bringing it in. Their string king knocking him off the puck. And you could see in the middle here, you could see that Zeus is there already splitting the defense. He's already looking to get back. The play continues on, and he is behind them before the pass is ever made. And that right there is one of the biggest no-nos, one of the things that as a goaltender, when you see that happen, it just drives you nuts because you're in a close game like this. You can't afford to pinch in too much. And I think, unfortunately, I think both Funky and MG may have been communicating or having a loss on communication there, and they just didn't see Madden's go right past them.
Yeah, you got the puck on the half wall over there, and Funky, he goes in to kind of play the puck a little bit. So he pulls over towards the right, and Zeus is already in between them. He's already got a step ahead of him in the middle of the ice. And then for whatever reason, MG, if you watch him, he backs up towards the left, even giving him even more space. And, yeah, terrible error. And, you know, it ends up being the play of the game, the goal of the game, and the difference in the game, and the reason why the Wolves won and the Manitoba Moose have lost this one.
Yeah, and again, we're looking at it again. Again, you know, Zeus just circling around the blue line, and that to me has got to be the point where you say to yourself, okay, what is he doing? He's obviously waiting for something. He's not necessarily playing defense because the puck doesn't look like it's coming back to him back to the points anytime soon. Both defenders are near him, but not necessarily on him enough. I think MG was aware of him, but before anything happened, String King, again, big part of that one, just had the puck, and as soon as he had it, he was flipping it out to Zeus, and it was just too quick for MG to respond to. And I think you know, MG tried to be there for it, but just was not able to get back in time. And so that one play, you could look at that over and over again, and I'm sure the guys on the Moose will do that. That one play right there could maybe have cost them the season.
Yeah, you got to get a body on that guy. You know, you got to get someone in front of him. You got to get a body on him. Can't just, you know, spread out and give him even more room.
Well, it's, you know, we're about 15 minutes away from another game starting up. Hopefully some of these will start up a little sooner. We're going to stay on here and just try and talk about what is going on with the playoffs right now. As you know, Springfield won their game, and so they are in the playoffs. The Bridgeport Sound Tigers have been eliminated now with that loss. And so if we look at the standings, and we'll take a look at them right now, you'll see that Springfield now up by 4 points with only one more game left to go. And we didn't get a final on that Bridgeport game, did we?
Bridgeport, I believe, won the game.
Okay, so so I guess technically they still could have a chance if Springfield would lose their game.
Yeah, I did close it out, but last I saw it was 5-2, I believe, in the third. So I think they won that game.
I don't think it's been recorded yet, and that's the issue that's stopping us from claiming anything at this point. They've got the Pens. Springfield has the Pens for the 10:30 game, and we're trying to get a final. The 9:30 game, it was Hartford beating Bridgeport 6-5. It says, that's the Wednesday game. Got that wrong. they don't make it easy here for you to find everything. Well, they sort of do, but it's so mixed up. We're trying to get that Thursday final, so we'll see. But apparently they won. But for whatever reason, I'm not catching it yet. So anyway, the Phantoms, they were playing the Phantoms tonight. And so in that first game, and we believe they won that one. So it is still a 2-point deficit at this point. For Bridgeport with the final game coming up. So we'll take a look at those games as well, see how that's faring and how that race is going. Meanwhile, in the Western Pacific, we still have a couple of teams racing there, San Diego and Tucson. What were the latest that you had for scores on that one as well?
I believe that, Tucson lost. Mm-hmm. Right, and San Diego, we never got a stream.
Okay, so
I have no idea about San Diego. Oh wait, they're actually on right now. Or is this still going to be the same not stream? Yeah, I don't know. I saw Tommy Legacy streaming. I don't know. Let's see.
Well, we'll try and get something on for you here shortly if we can get any kind of stream going. I don't.
Yeah, they never streamed the game for some reason. They just streamed Tommy Legacy playing a first-person shooter.
And unfortunately, the connections stay up for a while, so they can go into another game and of any kind.
Yeah,
they may still see their stream, but
unless maybe he walked onto the ice and killed everybody. I don't know. Who knows?
Well, we're looking to see if we can get a final here on these games. But a final here, Chicago 2-1 over the Moose, and that keeps the Wolves alive. And so we're looking to see what might have happened with that game. I don't know if somebody's talking about a forfeit, so we'll see if that has anything to do with that game or not.
Uh-oh.
Boy,
could there have been a forfeit?
We already had one of those with Rockford this week, and that's absolutely not something that you want to see in the final week of the season. Certainly not the final night of the season, and that's the last thing you want to see. And let's hope that wasn't the case tonight, that we... And we have something that's positive going on here, that we don't have a forfeit loss with any of these.
Yeah, because if goals. Yeah, because if that's the case, then Tucson would be out, right? Because if San Diego won and Tucson lost, that would be it, right?
Yeah, that would be it. They have a 1-point lead now.
Yeah.
If we get any kind of word on this right now, unfortunately, things are not recording that quickly, and trying to find information is never an easy task here. We're gonna hang out here for a bit, try and see where we are. if we've got something to bring to you on this one, and see if also if we can get I'm gonna see if we can get Madden's on here to talk about this as well.
I'm gonna see if I can figure out what the tie break is, because let's see. So they won 97.
Yeah, we're also trying to figure that out too with the league, because I don't think it's all that clear. But hopefully we'll get something from this.
Yeah. So it's not an alphabetical thing. I'm just looking on the standings. Right now, Manitoba is in fourth over the Chicago Wolves. So I don't know if that's because it's taking into account some sort of a tiebreak or whatever. So I don't know if Manitoba is still technically ahead of the Wolves, even though they are tied in points. I do know that Manitoba has 43 regulation wins. Mm-hmm. And Chicago has 42. So this is very interesting, Sibs, because if Chicago wins and Manitoba loses, they're in no matter what. If they both lose, I think Manitoba still gets in. And if they both win, I think Manitoba still gets in. So I'm pretty sure that Manitoba has to lose and Chicago has to win in order for Chicago to be in.
Coming right down to the end on this one, as you see, Charlotte also now with that victory up two on both of them. So, with more wins than both of them, it looks like the checkers are in at this.
Checkers are in. Yes, checkers are in. They will definitely be the third seed in the division. Still not 100% clear as to Manitoba and Chicago.
Speaking of Chicago, Madden's joins us here on the post game as we get ready for the second game of the night. And I know you've got to get going soon, but we quickly just wanted to get you on and congratulate you on the victory tonight. And, boy, I tell you what, you guys know how to make it really interesting right to the last night.
Yeah, I've been saying all week we like to live on the edge.
you know what? The action in the first period was not bad, but it still felt like it was a little tight. Maybe both teams not wanting to make a mistake. How did it feel the first period? Did you sense any of that, or do you feel like both teams were just trying to push as hard as they could?
Well, honestly, I think in the first period, I felt like we had a slight edge after, you know, just the way it played out. We got a few more shots off, but basically it felt about even. Kind of heard you guys talking earlier, kind of like what you said, we were feeling each other out. No one wanted to do a, you know, chance losing a lead right away, you know, so everyone played kind of safe on both sides, it seemed like.
And you guys get on the board with your goal from Zeus to make it 1-0. Talk a little bit about that play and how that started out.
He hit the second goal, I got the first one, but right. I know what you're talking about. Yeah, I remember the play because it had bounced all the way over to the corner on my side. Well, I mean, I'm playing defense, but it was on my side, you know, as a forward. So I remember I went in there to try to help, and I saw the center and the D-man come. Luckily, we knocked them free of the puck, and String came out with it and just made a great pass right up the gut, hit Zeus right on the money.
And so your goal to make it 1-0, that was the first goal in the second period. In the first goal of the game, talk to me a little bit about how that worked out.
You know, it was just a hustle play, and I just got to finish it. Basically, Zeus was pestering the guy with the puck. It bounced out. I mean, he was on the puck there, but I was already sitting there. And when I got it, I noticed the goalie was heavy on his glove side, and I was playing grinder. And I said, well, basically, you know, cross my fingers on this backhand shot. And luckily it went off the post, so right in there.
And you had that coming off of a power play, I believe. Manitoba had taken a penalty, and you guys were able to get yourselves going on the power play. And we're taking a little bit of a look of this play right now, showing the audience how this developed. And again, we're showing it now. As a good pass out front, and you were there. The puck bounced right out to you, and really, that's the only way. One of the few ways you're going to be able to beat Archie is if you can get him out of position. And he made a save initially, but found himself leaving half the net open there. And again, looked like you were just in the right place at the right time for that.
Yeah, I definitely have had a knack with, I would say, like, I know I'm up there in goals, but not so much points as a whole, but I always seem to have a good grasp usually on where the puck's going to bounce. Like, I played hockey in real life, and I played defense, actually, when I did that. So I guess take what I learned from that, you know, and try to put it to the video game. I know it's not exactly like real life, but, I mean, you can still get a good idea where you think the puck's going to go, you know, if you've seen the plays before.
Maddens, when the puck, like, when the puck jumps out and ends up on your stick like that, right in the front of the net, wide open net, anything go through your head? Are you worried about what if I send this thing flying over the top, or what? Just reaction? what goes on?
Right, like I said, I knew I was playing grinder before I took the shot, you know, so there was a little worry there, but I think it was mostly like, don't do a backflip before I shoot it was really what I was trying not to do.
Don't clear it down the other end of the ice.
Right. you know, you always dream things like that will happen, but when you, until it happens, you know, you're like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
What do you, so going into this last game again, you've got one more. What's your goal against Cleveland? What do you, you know, obviously they've played well. They've got, you know, they've got a solid line up and down right now. But coming off a win like this, do you think that helps to give your guys confidence going into this final game?
Yeah, I'll tell you what. I really like how that game went. Speaking of that, Cosmo had a great game. Mm-hmm. I'm hoping he bounces off that, has another stand-up game like that for us. Because really, I think we could beat any team. We usually score a few goals a game. So as long as we keep the other team from scoring a ton, we could usually pull it out. You know, so I have faith in my team. We played that game real heads up. I think we got to use the ECU in this last game, but, you know, it don't even matter. We're going to just try to get ahead and clinch down on that defense again.
Well, listen, we'll let you go. Best of luck in your game, and thanks for making this an exciting finish to the season. Good luck to you guys tonight.
Yeah, thanks, man. Just want to give a quick shout-out to my team, you guys. Come on, one more.
That's Maddens 26 joining us tonight as he heads off to his playoff game. Well, I guess it is a playoff game in a way, right? His final game of the season here in season four with a chance to be in the playoffs in Chicago. Did never say die because they are still in this right down to the end. We've got a couple of games about ready to start up vibes. And as exciting as it seemed before this game that we just called, even more exciting, I guess, at this point.
It is, Sibs. And I'm actually in the process right now of trying to confirm, but I believe, I'm not going to say 100% yet because I haven't confirmed it yet, but I do believe that despite winning that game, Chicago must win this last game.
Now, so even if they and Manitoba lose, it's going to be total wins, we're thinking, right?
Yes. So if they both lose, Manitoba would still be in. So the only way for them to get in, from what I'm hearing and what I'm understanding, is that Manitoba must lose and Chicago must win. So.
Well, this is going to be interesting. And I, if we can, I think what we're going to do is carry this Manitoba game if we can. I think it'd be interesting to get to see them again, backs against the wall, needing to win against a good team. And I think it'd be very interesting to see if they're able to do that. So hopefully we'll be able to bring you that game.
And I will certainly stay with pretty steady live updates of the Chicago and Cleveland game.
And I see that the Wolves are getting set up, and hopefully we'll be able to bring this to you shortly. We'll get you to the locker room eventually here. I see Tyler Lokey in net for this one for the Moose, and so Archmangus is not the starter in this one. And it looks like they have all their players in place. cholesterol bomb now in center for them. And so, again, will be a very interesting game. See how this works out. But we'll have this up on the screen for you shortly. Again, early game, the 9:30 game, it was the Chicago Wolves with a solid performance up and down, and winning on a breakaway goal in the second period by Prince of Zeus. A great pass by String King made it 2-0 at the time. The Moose were able to get a game go, get a goal in there later on in the game, but it was not enough, and the Chicago Wolves hold on to win and now tied with the Moose. And the Moose now getting ready to play the Iowa Wild. Well, it looks like they are going to have a bit of a problem getting this one started off, so we'll get back to that in a second. But they are going to play the Iowa Wild. Meanwhile, the Chicago Wolves are playing the Cleveland Monsters. We'll keep an eye on that game. And I think we may very well go back and forth between the two games. So,
yeah.
I think that's the best way to give you guys the best coverage.
Yeah. No, I think right now Cleveland is playing a warm-up game against Cap. I don't believe that's the Wolves. So, which they are winning 5-1 against that team. So.
Well, you know, you always got to wonder about these teams like the Wild and the Monsters. You know, how much do they care about this game? Do they feel the need to be competitive because it is so important to the other team, or are they relaxed about this game? I guess I've kind of been in that position this season because we had games like that this week with the Bears. We knew we were in. We knew we were first place in our division.
Well, I'll tell you this. Tryhard is playing the center for the Monsters in that game, and he only has one setting, and that's win. He doesn't have any sort of, whatever. He's a very competitive person, and he's gonna try and win this game, trust me.
No, there's a reason. I think he actually named himself properly because this guy hard. Does play. Yeah. He does try hard. He does play the game.
He tries hard.
And I don't blame him. That's the way you look. If you're going to play this game, you might as well play it that way.
Yeah.
And as you say, Cleveland is playing a warm-up game right now. And the Moose and the Wild are about ready to start their game up. So we will head to that one. Tyler Loki is giving us his camera angle, and we'll take a look at this one as we go along. And you see Bear again over to Kev Robert, but that is wide. And so now the Iowa Wild are starting out the other way. Tripping penalty now coming up against the Moose, and that will be a power play for the Wild. Delayed penalty. And we will stick with this game right now as it's going on. MG controlling and flips it out, trying to kill some time here. Wild in now. Loki staying to the post and able to thwart any effort there as the Moose come out.
Oh, I thought he actually hit me knocking off the puck. I'm like, Jesus.
Yeah, we've got Tyler Loki's feet, so he doesn't know he's part of the broadcast, but he is now. Right now, a little bit tight, both sides, as Iowa ices it, and so Manitoba with an opportunity deep in zone. Flip in front, and a dangerous play as the puck sits on the goal line. And that could have been a major issue for Price there. OMG Price has been solid all season long. That's a goaltender you don't want to go up against in your final game, do you?
Yeah, he's been good.
I'm out.
Minute left on power play for the Moose as they now have an opportunity with an extra man. Flip finding it somewhat difficult to get anything going here offensively. This power play has got 10 seconds left to go in it. And the Iowa Wild are controlling and flipping it out. So 5 minutes gone in the first period, no score. Moose in the Wild.
Tight game so far, huh?
Good.
Oh.
Opportunity just there as I said front. And
just as I opened my big mouth.
Tyler Loki with a good good save there on a good chance.
It's because I don't be trying to cover it with my goalie because it fucks me. Until I have
it. Not to kill the sound here, just so we don't have to listen to another team's chatter. But as you can see, Iowa controlling in deep in the Moose zone. Good block in front. Defense back there able to break things up.
Players are filling into the dressing room for that other game now.
And we'll get to that one as soon as we get a little bit of time here. But again, the Moose getting an opportunity there. Bear with a nice shot, trying to go back across the grain. Kev with an opportunity, but not able to connect. A good play, good defensive play, and love watching Loki play net. He absolutely likes to keep himself in good position. He doesn't leave that paint unless he needs to. But again, another good opportunity for Iowa. They're getting right in the slot vibes. They're not, they're not sitting on the outside. They're driving in.
Yeah, they've been the ones with the better chances so far. Well, basically the only chances so far. Oh!
And there you go. Kev Robert with the goal. Beautiful backhander. And he caught Price leaning a little bit to his right, leaving some of that net open, and Robert with a nice backhander. The Moose jumping out 1-0.
Kev Robert with the RKO out of nowhere.
Getting down to 4 minutes left to go in the first period, as you see, and now the Wild starting out again. But to watch the Moose defense. Shot gets through, even though they were spaced out pretty nicely there.
The other game is just getting set to start now. I would say who's involved, but I feel like the other game satisfies that in this particular situation.
We'll take this one down to the period before we switch over.
They are underway.
Wraparound attempt. Nice try there by the Moose. And seemingly have a little bit more of the offensive play going their way. They're being a little more aggressive, but not defensively, just the front line. And so we have a break in the action, so we'll head over to the other game. The Monsters and the Wolves. And this ought to be an interesting game. We'll keep an eye on both of these games tonight. And we'll get back to the other game shortly. We'll go back and forth here, but these are the these two games are certainly directly involve each other. We are looking at the camera of Optimus Rhyme in this one.
All right, I'll switch over to the other one then if you're going to stream that one.
Yeah, we'll go back and forth, but I want to get a little bit of time on this one right now.
Yeah, well, I just want to have the one that you don't have up.
Right,
no.
Right. Power play now for Cleveland, and that's going to give Chicago some time where they need to kill some penalty. Again, Cleveland, much like the Wild, really not much to play for here. except to be the spoiler. And they, this is what makes these games fun. So far, seems a little bit tight right now in this game. Not a lot of, great opportunities. Good clear by the monsters, wolves as they try and kill off this penalty. Now they are at even strength, and Cleveland having a little bit of an issue trying to get much going offensively.
It's quite a surprise.
Halfway through the first period here, and no score, Chicago-Cleveland. I'm going to trip on over to the other game now just to give you a sense of what's happening over there. And right now, still the Moose up 1-0 in this one. Big, big game for them. Boy, again, happened a couple of nights ago where the Moose were needing a win, not able to do it simply because they just had a tough game against Charlotte. As MG said in the pregame, just not able to figure out Charlotte this season. Not a good record against them. And so I think they only won once in five meetings against them. So if they're going to be in the playoffs and do some upsetting, they better hope they don't see the Checkers again, because they have had a big struggle. Big save there by Tyler Loki, keeping Manitoba in this one. And again, Vibes, another veteran, another guy who's got experience, who you got to believe doesn't get shaken by any of this. And he's played well in this game so far.
Yeah, and you know what? Sometimes those guys, even if throughout the regular season their stats aren't so amazing, sometimes those are the guys that can make the difference. Ooh. Cleveland's starting to ratchet it up now.
Seeing in the other game that the IceHogs are up on Charlotte right now, late in the first period, 1-0. Try and keep an eye on that game as well. But they're in it. Just curious to see how that's going to work out. And Iowa gets up on the board to tie it at 1. Power play goal. And that, again, penalty killing. And that's what MG talked about in the pregame. What are we going to do to keep ourselves out of the box? It's critical. And a penalty here cost them a power play goal. Oh, beautiful pass in front. And again, defense not able to stop that pass in Iowa. Now up 2-1 in this game. And the Moose have half a game gone, find themselves down by 1 and needing desperately to win this.
Nothing end of the first for Cleveland and Chicago.
And we'll bounce back and forth as we go along here. That game now certainly very critical. Another goal for Iowa, and this is starting to get a little bit ugly now for the Moose, who find themselves down 3-1 now, 5:41 left to go in the second. Had the play going in the first period, Vibes, and now all of a sudden, as you said, Iowa just turning it up.
You know, that's the thing about Iowa. You know, they'll just, out of nowhere, they just, it's like they hit the on switch, you know?
It'll be very interesting to watch them in the playoffs, say the least.
And the funny thing is that the Wolves are actually playing another team who also has an on switch.
Yeah, apparently. I'm going to flip over to that game, take a look at Cleveland and Chicago, and we'll keep an eye on the Moose game as well. But right now, let's take a look at this one for a while and see if Chicago can make any headway against a good Cleveland team. coming right down to the end. And I tell you what, we've had some interesting seasons, but the way this one is finishing up, it just goes to everything we've talked about in the weekly shows, Vibes, about the level of competition, the quality of player on every team. And we've got teams who are so close in three of the divisions, teams really right down to the last week, the last couple of nights, vying for a spot, tells you just how competitive it is. And I think it's just only going to get more competitive as the seasons go on.
Yeah, and you know what? In previous seasons, yeah, sure, it was intense and everything like that. But like you say, you know, not to just repeat exactly what you just said, but you're right. This season does have a different level of intensity and a different level of competition, one that I've never seen before in my four seasons here at LG. It's just been it's been a really crazy season.
Well, that's been the beauty of this is you made your comments about Chicago quite a few weeks ago, and I gotta say, I think just about everybody else in the show was like, okay.
That's just
Vibes being Vibes. You know, he's just trying to be a troublemaker. But, Chicago, you know, obviously having to deal with losing a very good player. But it's not just about what they wound up losing and how it affected them. It's how it affected them based upon the fact that if you lose a really good player like that, it's going to be very detrimental because of how good the other teams are.
Yep, absolutely. You know, you're at a certain level of, you know, a certain compete level, and if you get knocked down just a slight little fraction of a hair from that level, you know, next thing you know, you fall a few ticks on the belt. Oh, Cleveland just scored, so 1-0. Shot from the slot. I didn't catch you who scored it, but I think that, Cleveland's up 1-0.
I'll just double check on that, but it looks like it was Matt Sabb.
Oh, do you have that game up? I'm sorry. I didn't know you had that game up.
Yeah, I've got Cleveland up right now. Well, okay. I figure that might be the more interesting one at this point.
Yeah, at this point, yeah, you're right, yeah.
And another goal.
I thought you were watching the other one. Oh, wow.
Sab with his second goal, back-to-back tallies right now, halfway through this game. And if we'll probably stay with this one, because if Cleveland can close this one out, that will give the Moose a victory and give the Moose a playoff berth, and they won't have to worry so much about their game. But that's really on the other side of that, Vibes. That's not the way you want to go into the playoffs.
No, you don't want to go limping in. But you know, listen, at the end of the day, if you're in, you're in. If you're out, you're out. Right.
Right, so exactly,
you get in, you get in. I guess at this point, it doesn't quite matter, but you better believe it's going to matter next week. And I still wish that I can confirm that 100% sure beyond a shadow of a doubt. But that is the consensus here that we believe that no matter what Manitoba does, if Cleveland beats the Wolves here, the Wolves will be out. Can we say that as fact, Sibs, or should we still kind of tippy toe around that?
Yeah, I, you know what? We don't have a confirmation, and because the site isn't set up to, it's set up to look for wild cards, and based upon rules of the wild card. So the system still may tell us once all the scores are in, it still may say, well, at least we believe that
Yep.
So-and-so is going to be the wild card over the other team, and so that's probably going to be the thing. Sab, another goal, three now, all three of the goals for Cleveland, and it may all be a moot point, but we'll still try and get the answer for you because it's still kind of up in the air. Nobody still really knows what the answer is on that. So
yeah, hopefully we think we know, but we're not sure.
Yeah, no,
we
don't.
We think we know.
Well, that's typically how we work in general. Stop it. We think we know.
Right. We usually think we know. Except me, I know. No, but not in this case.
Well, again, we're going to keep an eye on this Cleveland game. I think that's the one we want to check on. We'll get you an update on the other game. It looks like it's 4-1 right now in favor of the Wild. So both teams at a three-goal deficit. the likelihood of either one of them coming back. I tell you what, Chicago's going to need a miracle right now, and they've had to deal with that, but they're facing a very tough Cleveland team, and I think both them and the Moose would have a tall order to get back into this, but especially I think Chicago. But give them credit for not giving up, Fibes.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. You know, and I there really should not be any give up in this league. You know, that's not hockey. I understand it's a video game, but that's not hockey. And at the end of the day, we are playing hockey.
Well, that's true. Absolutely. This looks like the second period is coming down to the end here. With the Cleveland Monsters up by 3, we'll flip over to the other game. It looks like they have a timeout right now, but interesting game so far. Matt Sabb 15-15 with the hat trick so far for the Monsters and giving them right now the 3-0 lead in that game.
The thing about the Monsters is, you know, tonight you have Matt Sabb. He's got 3 goals. You know, the next night it could be Tryhard with 3 or Coatesville with 3 or anybody with 3. And that's the scary thing about this Cleveland team moving forward into the playoffs is that any one of these guys can jump up and, you know, bite you.
Well, look, we saw Tryhard last year with the Checkers and just playing some tremendous hockey in the AHL last season. Just didn't work out this season with Columbus, but he's back at this level with the talent level that he's at. And you know, say what you want. I certainly don't want to get into a discussion about what Cleveland did again, but you know, they have players now on their roster that are NHL caliber that are going to be a big part of the playoffs, and you have to deal with it whether you like it or not.
Absolutely, and you mentioned Tryon, you know, and he'll go on to have a successful NHL career, and you know, he's just a player that's got a certain poise on the ice, you know, and that's something that you can't really teach it, you know, it just could, either you got it or you don't. And he just has a great way of picking his play. You know, he doesn't take the play that's the only play that's there right away. He waits for his play, and then he takes it.
I remember a couple of seasons ago, I was with Broski heading up the Tucson team. And every practice game, every tryout game we had, pretty much every one of them, Tryhard was there playing, showing the intensity that he had for the game. And I, you know, I have a lot of reasons to not like Broski, but that's definitely one of them where I felt like, maybe he might be too intense for some people, but I like his attitude. I like his play. And he's a guy we need to go out and get. And unfortunately, we didn't get him. I wish we had tried harder because he wound up, again, last season just being fantastic for the Checkers. And he's one of those guys that, you know, you don't know a lot about. You play with him a bunch of times. And do you trust what you see? Or do you go for a veteran or somebody who's been around that you know a little bit better? He was a guy, I think we saw the signs that he had the talent to play well. And, boy, has he turned out to be an excellent player.
Yeah, and still, you know, young in his career. You know, he's just a kid coming up through the ranks, and, you know, he comes out of nowhere. He has that season with Charlotte last season, and now here he is again, this time with Cleveland. Yeah, things didn't work out in Columbus, but that's, you know, that's all temporary, and I'm sure he'll eventually get his footing up there as well. But, I mean, you want a guy with intensity. You know, intensity is good. Hey, listen, it's good to have intensity. It's not good. Oh, another one there. It's not good to have negativity. You know, intensity is good, negativity isn't. And he's an intense player, not really a negative player.
Matt Sabb with his 4th goal of the game. Now we are watching this Cleveland game full time. And we'll take a look at this now for the rest of the way. And depending on how this one ends, if it is a Cleveland victory and a Chicago loss, we'll endeavor to get MGM back on, see if Dead Soul's even on. I'm not sure if he's available tonight, but I'd love to get them both on to talk about this season and you know what their how they feel about how it ended, because it's certainly again, if you're a GM and AGM, this is heartburn and ulcer time.
Yeah. And I really wish I could get someone to throw me a lifeline as to whether or not these guys, if it is how we think it is with the tiebreak. You know, I don't know if I could phone a friend and maybe take the 50-50 or something, but someone toss me a lifeline so we can, oh, wow, another one, figure out exactly where we stand here.
Yeah, well, again, we'll try and, you know, there are a lot of rules that are listed on the site. Sometimes it's not so easy to find a clear definition, and so
Dead Soul will know. We'll Dead Soul will that. Know.
Yeah. I hope you're right.
He'll know.
Look at this: Chicago 5 shots on goal so far in this game. After that win against the Moose, this is a tough way to go out, and I'm sure this is not at all what Zeus was hoping for. You know, at least a good competitive game. It just hasn't turned out that way tonight for Chicago and Cleveland on their way to a victory here in this one. And the Manitoba Moose on their way to a playoff berth with this loss. See if we can get any other information on the other games that are going on with Tucson and with San Diego. Don't really know if we have any idea what's happening with those games.
All right.
Another goal for Cleveland, and just a heartbreaking game for Chicago.
Still trying to find out what happened with that 9:30 game for the goals. Oh, the goals lost that game. They forfeited that game.
Wow.
So, all right.
That is unfortunate.
Yeah, that's the goals forfeited that game. But now,
so we'll try and figure out what's going on in the West as well, because this is this is tough. Well, anyway, as we see this Cleveland game with Chicago entering its last minute, Chicago Wolves playing an excellent game against the Moose. And whew, I tell you what, both these teams having to go up against very strong teams to end the season, the schedule just not working out for them, either one of them.
Yeah. I would not relish the idea of being third or fourth in that Central Division.
Yeah, they may be just maybe a stay of execution at this point.
Yeah, I believe so. I think Tucson and the Condors are tied at one. Let me confirm that.
Yeah, I was looking at that game. I wasn't sure if that was actually the game, since we are late. And they were in the first period, but it was it may very well be the case.
Yeah, I don't know if that could have been a restart or something.
Yeah, I venture to guess that's probably the case.
Yeah.
If we can get some up, and again, we're just trying to get a some sort of clarity on the playoff rules. Again, it's not going to be an issue, but we'll try and at least get some answer on this for you.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on with the goals. I think the goals might have... Could they have forfeited both games tonight? That would just be catastrophic.
Cleveland again scoring 7-0. Very disappointing to go out this way. And Cleveland certainly not giving up in the last seconds. Win this one 7-0. And a very, very disappointing game there for Chicago. The Monsters, yeah. Certainly, again, as we've said this many times, firing on all cylinders heading into the playoffs, and that's not good news for anybody.
Yeah. So I believe that will end the Wolves season.
Golds had the Barracuda at 10:30, and I...
Yeah, I'm trying to get word now.
Yeah, I don't see any confirmation that anything's going on with that game right now.
I'll try to ask Intro. I'll message him.
Well, anyway, we're going to have these finals in shortly, and so we'll have the official word on all this. But Charlotte is in, Manitoba... and Chicago both losing this game, this final game, but we believe Manitoba will win the tiebreaker. Both teams at 95 points, and so we do need to get an answer on this, and hopefully we'll get something for you soon. It's a bit of a struggle right now, but we have not been able to get in touch with anybody within the bog in LG for AHL. We'll try and see if we can get somebody on to explain the rules for you, and hopefully we can get this all cleared up and make sure that we understand what's what here. Oh, can certainly get a lot of speculation in the chat, but we want to make sure that we have the right answers here.
Yeah, we're looking for the actual official word.
Anyway, a couple of games tonight that we were able to bring you. Certainly that first game, Chicago and Manitoba. Again, the Wolves winning that one 2-1. The kind of game that you expect to see from two teams really struggling to make the playoffs. And so, really interesting just because it was such an important game for both teams. You almost wish that game had happened for 10:30, not the 9:30 game.
Sibs, Intro just said in the shout box, great season, boys. So I don't know if that means that they could be out. I don't know if they forfeited that second game, maybe.
Yeah, we need to find out.
Yeah. But I think these scores will filter in here pretty soon, and we'll find out for sure.
Well, we are chat boxing. we're as much as you guys are, so we're gonna get some answers from somebody here. We're gonna see if we can get a couple of answers in a few minutes. I wanted to get Dead Soul on here to talk about what's going on here, but he is stuck in a different league, we'll say, in a different game, and so we may or may not get him on. We'll see how much longer we want to go with this. We'd like to be able to tell you what the official playoff teams are for this, but again, since the site isn't really set up for it properly, it's incredibly hard to tell you.
I would love to hang out until we know for sure.
Well, we will see if we can get some other folks on here to talk about their season. Let's see if MG is busy. See if he can answer the call and jump on with us and talk a little bit about what's going on here, since he's our partner on the show anyway.
Put the champagne down, MG. You haven't won anything yet.
Well, He's probably, if he saw that at the end of the other game, and I'm assuming he probably did watch it, I got to believe he was watching that game pretty intently. And MG, sorry to bother you unannounced, but we figured we'd get you back on here to talk about the way these last two games finished up. Your game, the Cleveland-Chicago game. That first game was amazing, but certainly – you guys, both teams, yours and Chicago, had an opportunity to maybe steal one and make it easy. Unfortunately, both of you had to go up against some really buzzsaw teams right now. But maybe you could help us out here. I mean, you're part of the weekly team. We don't have full confirmation on who makes the playoffs at this point. Is it the team with the most wins? Did you get any confirmation?
Most wins is the first tiebreaker. Yep.
Okay.
Right. Okay, that's what I thought. So that's it. You guys are in.
Yep.
Well.
Well, congratulations. Yep. As tough as it is to win this way.
I don't know. It is frustrating, and I feel bad for Chicago. I mean they're a team that deserves to be in the playoffs. I mean, you put up 95 points in the season, and you're on the outside. It's a frustrating thing. I mean, both of us should be in the playoffs right now.
We didn't get a chance to talk to you about that first game, but it was about as exciting as we thought it was going to be, just simply because of the play throughout it. You guys, both teams looked a little bit tight the first period.
I think you could cut the tension with a knife in that arena. Pretty. I think both teams were gripping their controllers a little tighter than usual.
How was it in your party? Were your guys pretty quiet during the game in the first period, or was there a lot of
tension? No, we were talking. I think maybe I mean, you played with me, Sibs. I can be a bit of a motor mouth during the games, especially when it's a big game. I think I probably didn't help with the stress levels with my constant narration of the game, but it was. I think we stayed pretty positive. I think we never counted ourselves out. I mean, it was a close game. It could have gone either way.
All right, so just to interject here real quick, so the San Diego Gulls did win 2-1 over the Barracuda in game two.
Okay, so that would put them in the playoffs then.
I believe that they are in, yes. And I'm hearing, I'm not 100% sure yet, but I'm hearing that it is Bridgeport that will be in the Atlantic.
And that is based on...
That is based on me trying to dissect the shout box.
Well, that's interesting. I think we have to...
what a crazy season, though, to have so many teams in the very last game of the season still fighting for a playoff spot. I mean, that's...
Oh, it's been crazy.
I've never
it's
seen been it like
unreal.
This.
No, it's been unreal. This is like... We were just talking before. It's been craziest, most exciting season thus far. And that's great for the league. I mean, it's only great to get better and better and better. And this has been amazing.
It's... What we were talking about, MG, was just the fact that... The talent level is such that again another factor that we've talked about all season long, again as to why these divisions, three of them coming down to the last night pretty much to figure out who was going to go. We certainly hadn't seen that in the first three seasons, and definitely the talent level a big part of that. We also said that we talked a little bit about Chicago. And how they struggled, did losing one player mean that much? Well, the stats kind of proved that out a little bit. But, one thing we were saying, and I want to get your opinion on it, is that because the competition is so close, you lose one really solid player like HJ, and that puts you in a big bind, not so much because it makes your team that much worse, but because it's any kind of... Anything that you can exploit against a team like that, if your team is stacked and most of them are in this league, you're going to take advantage of it.
Oh, exactly. I mean, it's not football, but it's a game of inches. I mean, there's just so many things that can help you push you over the edge or can make you lose a season. I mean, the Wolves at the beginning of the season looked like they were going to be unstoppable. They had, and it, I think it just kind of slowly fell apart for them. Lineup issues. I think they had some trouble on defense as well with Lunchbox Hero. And those are things that you can't really factor for when you're going into the season. You think you have your roster set, and then that's the problem being in the AHL, is you really don't have 100% control of your lineup, and you can only do so much. And certain teams are going to be luckier; they're not going to have interference from their NHL owners, and some teams get the short end of the stick, and it costs them.
Well, it looks like at this point we're gonna have Dead Soul on in a few minutes here. He is finishing up another game right now. I wanted to get him on to talk with you as well, MG, just to wrap up the season a little bit. Try and get a little preview of our show coming up this Sunday.
Yeah,
maybe at least for a few minutes here. And
boy, is that going to be a lot of fun.
Well, again, We've watched a lot of teams in the last week or two that were vying for playoff spots, and we've kind of gotten off the teams that were dominating. We did quite a few games of them early to mid-season, but now we're going to get a chance to see these top-flight teams again. And, I wonder, just by watching these late games, especially the Cleveland game, with Chicago, I wonder if there is, how big of a disparity there is between number one versus number four in each division. In the Eastern Atlantic, I don't think it's that much. I think Springfield.
I think there's a jump from Hershey, but I think 2, 3, and 4. I think there's not much separation there. I think Hershey's is far enough ahead of the rest of them, but.
Well, I tell you what, at the risk of having my teammates want to kill me, I don't know if that's actually, I don't know if I agree totally with that. I think the other teams have improved. I think we got out to a nice lead. I think the other teams have made some moves, but also just are playing better as teams. And I think it's not as big of a disparity as you think. Wilkes-Barre Scranton, was a top team right with us the whole time, and it wasn't until later that we pulled away. The Bruins, yeah. I wouldn't have pegged them as a playoff team early on the season.
I think you can give Killer Scotch a good chance at winning the GM of the year this year. I mean, he took a team that was, I was on Providence week one, and it was a shit show. I mean, it was complete chaos over there, and somehow losing Jan Sanity when he was banned or quit, Killer was able to step in, make some moves, and put a playoff team together. I think that's pretty impressive for a team that looked like it was going to be a bottom feeder the first couple weeks.
Dead Soul joins us now, and congratulations on making the playoffs here. We've just been talking to MG for a little while. Do you have any hair left? Any fingernails left at this point? Watching the end of the season occur?
Yeah, well, that was, those were quite the games to be playing. And, I think we did what we could. We did pretty good. Good job there, MG. Good try tonight. I know, there's some tough losses there against some very, good teams. And fortunately for us, the Wolves weren't able to get that second win that they desperately needed to be able to stay in the playoff position there. So, thanks Monsters for that little bit of help, I guess.
Yeah. But I mean, I think we got to give props to our whole team though, for pulling together this week and putting up the kind of week that we had. I mean, we needed to have, one more loss, one less point, and we're out of the playoffs. So, We won some big games. I mean, our game against Cleveland, that was especially after a tough loss to the Checkers, to come back and get those points, two big points against Cleveland, that was a big part of our season.
Huge win, and the fact is we did come together as a team. Everybody did their part, did what we could, and this last week we did, I thought, very well the last several games. So, we did what we could in terms of keeping our spot and trying to get a little bit more ahead if we could. And unfortunately, we didn't get that third spot that we were at least gunning for. But, you know, we went down with a fight and we still were able to pull it off. And again, yeah, that was a whole team effort.
The, you know, you guys were toiling at fourth, fifth the whole season. And, you know, did you feel like something had to happen to Chicago or Charlotte? Did you feel like you had enough to catch up to them? Was it going to take, you know, something going on with one of these teams as it did with Chicago to give you the break? Or did you think that there was still just as good of a shot no matter what, with or without the Wolves having the kind of slip that they had late in the season?
Well, we were definitely neck and neck with Charlotte most of the way, and I mean, we knew that they were the kind of the team that we were after and just constantly fighting for. I personally didn't really foresee the collapse of the Wolves. I know Vibes obviously said his piece a while back, but
start him.
Yeah, no, it's just I'm honestly a little surprised about that. But when you lose some big players, key players like they did to the NHL, I mean, it obviously had their effect, and they haven't really been able to quite recover from that, unfortunately. But unfortunately for us, so.
I think maybe this Sunday we're going to have a bit of an autopsy for the Chicago Wolves, because
I'll tell you what I'm gonna save my I told you so's for the show. I'm not gonna do it tonight.
Oh yeah, that'll be probably about 50% of the show, I'm sure.
Yeah, I'm gonna save it for the show.
That's, you gonna be able to hold on to that for a few days, or is it gonna?
Yeah, no, because that'll make it better, because then I'll have to really hammer it home that I told you so. So we'll hold it.
It's going to fester and bubble inside of him until he can't hold it anymore.
But we will, I think that we will certainly go into the, like you said, the autopsy of the monumental collapse of the Chicago Wolves.
Well, it's, I tell you what, I do feel for them, because that is tough. I think we do need to dig into it, because I'm not 100% convinced it was one player that caused it. But it needs to be said that this is part of the game. And as much as people want to complain about, you know, sending guys down from the NHL to help out the AHL, the other side of that coin is you can lose good players to the NHL if they need them. If the management decides that they're gonna pick from you whether you like it or not, there are all sorts of reasons why you lose good players, and it's all part of the game. But it's a part that, you know, as much as people were complaining about the Cleveland thing, you know, nobody's crying tears for Chicago other than Chicago, I guess, for losing good players along the way.
Yeah.
Yeah, it hurts to lose any player.
I mean, it's a good point, but I mean, one player didn't make them lose 7 games this week or 8 games this week.
No, but you know what? It is a snowball effect. There is definitely a snowball effect from losing HJ. That, you know, it's like dominoes. You know, the first domino falls, and the next thing you know, you got a big fucking mess you got to clean up. But that's a whole other story. It all starts with that first domino. Yeah, they still have a good team.
And to lose to Milwaukee this week, to lose games that they are better teams than. I mean, if they beat Milwaukee this week, they're in the playoffs right now, and we're on the outside. I mean, we won the game.
Listen, this is great ammunition for the show on Sunday. This is wonderful ammunition for the show. But you guys should have known that you were going to get in, honestly, because I said that you were gonna. So you should have known.
Oh, yeah, well.
You got the vibe, the stamp of approval.
You know, once I told you the Wolves were going to be out, you should have known.
Wait, hold on a second, though. You did say in the pregame, though. You remember what you said in the pregame?
What did I say in the pregame? I have no idea what you're talking about.
Well, right, now that Dead Soul Mirror in here, all of a sudden he's got to amnesia.
He, to the shock and amazement of me, said that he thought the Wolves could pull that game out.
Well, I did. You know what? I really did. But at the end of the day, I thought, honestly, if you really want to know the truth, I thought that the Wolves would have been out probably about a week, 2 weeks ago, is what I really thought. I thought that the collapse was going to be a lot more of a downhill, you know, a more steep downhill collapse. And they had that one good week against, they had, it was like, it wasn't even a good week, but they went like 6-3 or something like that. And honestly, that prolonged the whole process. Otherwise, the Wolves would have been out over a week ago.
I also think Cleveland or Charlotte and us also had some struggles going down the stretch.
You guys did, yes. You guys also had your struggles as well. But honestly, this Chicago team probably should have been out over a week ago.
But I mean, you put the Chicago team in two of the other divisions, and they're sitting in a playoff spot right now.
Yeah, so. Yeah, right. Yeah,
yeah, and they're a good team. They played well overall.
Yeah. Yeah.
I will say I want to give a bit of a shout-out to Cosmo, a fellow show host on Sunday there. That first stop of the game, I mean, that would have set the tone right there for us if we had scored that goal. And right. That big pad save he made in the first 30 seconds of the game, that definitely shifted the momentum into their favor, I think, right off the bat.
Yeah, he played a hell of a game, too, that first game against you guys.
He did.
You know, and I tell you what, I took something positive for you guys from both these games I saw tonight, and that is that even in the loss in the second game, I saw two very good goaltenders for your team tonight, and I think that is a pretty strong suit for you guys to go into the playoffs with. I think if you can go in with two strong, confident goaltenders, which you guys seem to have, anything's possible. They could be the difference no matter what your defense, the rest of your defense and your front line's doing.
I agree. Both Tyler and Arch can steal games when they want to, and they've been probably the two most consistent players in our team all season, game in, game out. I mean, they obviously have the odd off game here and there, but most of our losses were not because of goaltending. They were,
no. And we're going to be, you know, looking to correct that over the, you know, the weekend and moving into the playoffs. I mean, we know our weaknesses. We know what needs work. You know, we definitely know that there's things that need to be done to tighten up as a whole group. And I think we're all capable and willing to do that now. And I mean, the fact that we were able to pull together the wins that we were at the end here, like, it was must win games. We won the majority of the games we must, you know, had to have won, minus a couple of these tonight. But you know, I think we're going to come back strong from this, and it's just going to be, you know, a good learning experience for us to just move forward and see what we can do to beat these teams coming up, or at least the Wild looks like.
I mean, that's all. I mean, once you get a ticket to the show, anything can happen, right? So,
right. Yeah, I know we're going to be the underdogs again, so it'll be interesting.
Yeah. So, just looking now, all the games that mattered are in. All the games that we needed to be in for the 82 marker are in, and we now know exactly what the matchups are going to be. I don't know if you want to shout them out there real quick.
No, I mean, you could handle it.
Okay. All right. Yeah, sure. So, in the Eastern Atlantic, we're going to have T-Sibs and Hershey Bears going up against the Bridgeport Sound Tigers. That is your 1-4 matchup. We got the Wilkes-Barre Scranton Penguins at number 2 going against the Providence Bruins. So, pretty good matchups in the Eastern Conference. I'm sure we'll have a good time with that on Sunday, huh?
And the first of three divisions, and you're going to talk about the other two, the first of three divisions where the fourth seed and the fifth in that division end up with the same amount of points, and a tiebreaker of wins needed to happen.
Tiebreaker. Yep, tiebreaker situation. So through the tiebreaker, that ends up being your matchups. In the East and North, we have the Syracuse Crunch, who have been – actually, hang on just a second. I didn't even realize that Syracuse jumped the Marlies.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Wow, I feel like I just woke up from a really long nap or something. So Syracuse is going against the number 4 Utica Commons. That's your 1-4. Your 2-3 are the Toronto Marlies versus the Binghamton Senators. So,
yeah, the Crunch are my team to watch there. So I know.
Interesting.
I think Binghamton could be a real dark horse going into this playoffs. They've quietly been a dominant team this whole season.
Yep. Yes, they definitely have, and we'll definitely dive into that more Sunday. I tell you what, you guys are not going to want to miss the Sunday show, because we're going to have some really good material, and it's going to be something you definitely want to tune into. Jumping over into the Western Central, the most, if you ask me, the most exciting division all year, especially coming down the stretch. I mean, this was like... I get the hairs on the back of my neck stand up just talking about it. You know, the Iowa Wild will be going up against the Manitoba Moose. And then we have the Cleveland Monsters going up against the Charlotte Checkers. Who, if we're talking about dark horses, you know, that Charlotte Checkers team is a really good team. You know?
Yeah.
It's a really good team.
And depending on matchups, they could really steal a game against Cleveland if the Monsters are not careful.
Yep, yeah, that's a dangerous Checkers team, so definitely keep an eye on that one. And then in the Western Pacific, another really close race coming down the stretch. Got the Stockton Heat coming in number one, and they will be playing against the San Diego Gulls. So that's your 1v4, and then Texas Stars versus the Bakersfield Condors, and. I know some of us feel certain ways about certain teams in this division, MG. You know what I mean?
That's right.
definitely an interesting division out there as well.
You know, I think this proves a pretty good point, though, as far as every single game matters from game one to game 82. I mean, three teams are on the outside looking in, because they lost in overtime instead of or lost twice in overtime instead of getting one extra win. One win is the only thing that separated them from being in the playoffs.
Yeah, and you want to know something? If one of those teams that ended up on the outside, like, forfeited a game or something during the year, well, that's your season right there. So that just goes to show you how important that type of stuff is, right?
Yep, exactly.
And, of course, Manitoba making it in. They were tied for points with Chicago here at the end. And
one single win, yeah. That's all it took.
San Diego and Tucson, again, 89 points to finish the season out. San Diego, one more win. And I thought maybe one of them would wind up this way of the three. All three of these divisions we've been talking about wind up with the fourth playoff spot being determined by one more win by the team. Just incredible. I don't know how, you know, I don't know if that's going to happen again anytime soon, but that is just an incredible down to the wire, by a nose kind of win.
Yeah, photo finish. And not just a two horse race.
So, what do you guys do now? You know, as far as, you know, you're in, you're past, hopefully past the theatrics of what this week was. How quickly do you feel like you're going to get your guys in Manitoba back on track, and now let's just point this truck towards the playoffs and only worry about that?
I think, well,
go ahead.
Personally, we gotta get going right away. I mean, I know myself, I plan on scouring as many Iowa games as I can to try to pick up anything that I can as far as what we can do defensively or offensively to find a weakness, basically, that we can attack.
Yeah, they're just such a strong team, like, throughout all the lines, and defensively, offensively, they're just a huge threat in every category. So we can't take them lightly whatsoever. You know, we definitely have to do our homework. We certainly have to do our practice, and we got to shut those guys down, find a way to do it, and certainly find an answer to the their goaltending with oh my God, Price there and his stellar performance that he seems to bring every night.
Well, you got a little bit of a taste of that tonight, so I got to believe that going forward, you're going to have to look back at your matchups with them and see what you need to do differently.
Yeah, we had a lot of close games in the season. A lot of it came down to one-goal games for the most part. It's not like it was a blowout in either direction, but we know that we can have those tight, close games. We know that we can actually keep them at bay, and we certainly need to start putting up more goals against them if we can, and that's really going to have to be the key, obviously, and it's going to be an exciting matchup either way, and I think we're just going to have to really prepare mentally as well as just with our practice in general.
At a 5-3. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Sorry, Sibs. I don't want to cut you off there, but can any of you confirm when the playoff starts? Is it this Sunday or is it next Sunday?
From the timetable, I mean, we moved the season up a week, right? So
yeah, exactly. But it still says the playoff is the 16th, right? Officially in writing.
Yeah, I mean, typically, unless there's a reason, we don't take a week off, but I think we're going to have to get that confirmed for sure. This is what happens when schedules are shifted, when the website is looking at wild cards instead of the top four teams. I think none of this is clear right now. We're going to have to get some clarity on it. I don't know for sure. I assumed it was starting this Sunday, but we're going to have to find out for sure. I was just going to quickly talk about the fact that what you guys have done against the Wild, a 5-3 victory in week one, then in week three, 2-1 by the Iowa Wild. I don't think you faced them again until week number seven, a 4-3 loss in that one, and then, of course, tonight, 4-1. Loss in that game, and I tell you what, watching your 4-1 loss and watching the 7-0 loss that Chicago had against Cleveland, you both were facing pretty strong teams, but despite that, you guys stayed in it. The Wild turned it on there in the second period, got a couple of goals that could have been a runaway train, but your guys stopped the bleeding, and Loki was there to help out with that. He made some tremendous saves in that period. Could have been a lot worse. And so I think the competition that you guys have with a top team like the Wild is such that I don't know if we're going to, I think we're going to see some close games. I think you guys know how to keep it close no matter who you're playing.
Yeah, I think that's going to be exactly that way, at least obviously hoping we can maintain that. But I know one thing that's been going against us for the season, as I've said before, the lines situation, that's why we had a few different setups this week, to see if we can move that around. We just haven't really had the consistency like the Wild, I know, definitely has over the last couple of seasons with their lines. They might have shifted some guys here and there, but I know for us, a big weakness over the entire season has just been not able to make those strict three lines. Moving forward, we're going to have to go with what works best, what's worked the best over the season, and hope that the schedules work out perfectly for this setup. So I think if we can actually manage to get those lines that we've had that worked really well together during the season and just practice those, I think we're going to be in a really good spot.
Well, listen, guys, best of luck to you. We're going to obviously get to see a few of your games in the playoffs, and now comes the hard part: who's playing when? that's never fun.
Exactly.
Vibes, any final thoughts from tonight? I'm exhausted. I don't know about you.
Just make sure you guys bring plenty of water for the show on Sunday. That's all. Drink plenty of water and stay well, very well hydrated. And I can't wait.
Yeah.
I think you should worry about the water and lozenges. I think the rest of us may just want to bring a pillow in case we need to lay down and take a nap while you're on your tirade.
I'm always on my best behavior.
Well, thanks to both of you guys for doing the commentating tonight on all the games. It's always fun to watch and makes it that much more exciting and interesting. And certainly it's been fun to have you guys do that.
Thank you, man. It was a lot of fun for us as well.
Just an awful lot of fun, as always, tonight. Well, we're going to wrap it up here. We've been on for way too long, and it's time for us to go. So thanks for joining us tonight. We've had a lot of fun bringing the games. Thanks to the Manitoba Moose and MG for streaming for us tonight. A great season. A great season four that is not over yet. The regular season's done, but now we get to launch a lot of good playoff hockey. For Vibes, MG, Dead Soul, this is T-Sib saying so long, and we will talk to you on Sunday with our playoff preview.